Ladies and gentlemen, Silent Mike, back with another video. People have been asking, where's the updates? We're here to tell you. We got a lot done and nothing done at the same time. Sometimes with some of these projects, the productivity only feels good when you can visually see something. Although progress is being made, some of the visual stuff, one big project is done, and now we're chipping away at the rest. So, if you wanna know what's happening with gym and apparel, give this thing a thumbs up. We're diving into the video update. I think about a week ago, not really, 5 days ago? 5 days ago, we finished the full seal and polish of the floor. And basically, multiple reasons for it. One, the aesthetic of the stain we wanted to add. We shout out to everybody on Instagram that have hit up me or the boys. We got a lot of compliments on it, which is cool. I didn't think people cared about floors, but it seems y'all are digging it. Like a lot of compliments on the floors. Like a weird amount where I'm raising eyebrow like, man, people are really into floors. Like, thank you. That feels good. Because we put a lot of effort into it, the design of it, and the actual physical labor. So the seal to make it waterproof, clean proof, dust proof, and then a polish to protect that seal. Now I'm not Bob Villa, but basically what we want to do is you got raw concrete, we put the stain on there to protect the stain, a urethane acrylic seal, multiple coats of that, and then the polish, just regular floor polish to protect that. So then we can just dust this thing, keep it nice and pretty, gives it a little shine. It made the floor a little bit darker from the original stain, which I actually think turns out great. It matches our rafters, which are exposed wood, and will tie into the rest of what's going on. So we're gonna walk you through not only aesthetically what we plan to do, but a little bit of the gym function that we plan to do. So main door, as you come in from the parking lot, we're planning on trying to work in a premium membership where we have key fob 24-hour access for those that have a little bit more to spend on their hobby and can't work around our typical hours. The team is four of us, and so we're not gonna be here 24/7, hence the premium membership, which may be the other door. But we do have a parking lot and main door. This whole area that I'm sitting in right now, and we kind of set up shop with our table, will be a full retail store, plus like basic concessions. We're thinking some kind of caffeine to get you going, some kind of water, hydration, our own gear, 3SB, Third Street Athletics gear, and front desk to check in. So we're gonna aesthetically try to pimp it out a little bit more like a boutique, a little bit more like a retail area. The back wall here will be beautified a bit. We're thinking about doing accent walls. Typically an accent wall when you do a house or a bedroom or a living room, a lot of times you'll throw a color. So you'll have some neutral stuff and then you'll throw a shade of maroon or a shade of green or a shade of blue. Because we still want this hardcore vibe with an elevated aesthetic and balancing what feels like a gym, what feels like I'm about to get to work, like time to sweat, it's okay to get a little dirty, a little chalky, with kind of an elevated vibe of, man, this place is nice and it gives me good mojo. It makes me feel swaggy. Is there like a new term, drip, I guess? What's the new Zoomer term for swag? Comment below for those kids that just hang out on Urban Dictionary all day or are cooler than me. Let me know what that word is. So what we're thinking for our accent walls, because we don't want like a bright color, because we really like our cinder block look, which is the majority of the space, 90% of the space is that, we're gonna add some metal accents. We got some really cool corrugated metal on the outside of the building with our address and with these industrial yet modern looking lights. So we're gonna try to bring that outside and inside. So we're gonna do probably one or two accent walls of metal in this. We're calling this B-side. This what will probably turn into the retail and kind of power building accessory space. So our aesthetic side. We're gonna have the dumbbells, the machines, the cables, everything over here. So we'll do behind the front desk metal, and then one other accent wall will be mirrors for the getting your bicep pump on your way out, and an accent wall right here. Then you'll step into the A side, we're calling it, which will be the main barbell room. We'll have layout of along the walls will be all our half racks and racks for your major lifts, the squats, the overheads. You can even do some power cleans. We'll have some bumpers and wood platforms to get your groove on. Middle space will stay open, but we'll have deadlift platforms. So you can do other things there, RDLs, rows, deadlifts, obviously, kind of middle of the room. We want to keep it open in case we want to have events, and whether it be powerlifting events or just community events. We want it to feel open. If you start clogging everything and you do rows of racks everywhere, I feel the space then becomes claustrophobic, and it also, again, feels like that university style gym that everyone has. Every CrossFit and university and strength gym just has a row of racks or a row of a rig. And we're trying to go, not against the grain, but again, taking tradition while evolving the culture a bit. When you step into A side and you go to the left, we're gonna have the combo racks. They'll probably be set up as benches because that'll be our main benching station, but obviously you can move it and switch it into squat stations if you want, if all whatever, you know, 6, 7, 8 racks over here are taken. That'll be another option. On the far wall, there's another door you'll see, and that leads you into what will be our room, basically. It's Connor's rooms, Jim's rooms, Kyle's room. It'll be podcast. Employees only. We will have a podcast studio and probably YouTube studio in there. Will that be open to the public in some nature? Maybe eventually. First, it's just for our work, our creative, that I'll probably set up an office for myself. My office at home is very functional and I get work done really well there, but it doesn't, like, I don't step into it and feel creative. So I'd like to even build my own space and one for the boys that we really feel good being creative, being motivated, have our own corners, maybe our own desk decorated, et cetera, et cetera. Mine at home is cool. I have my Star Wars stuff, I have my stream set up. It feels good, but it doesn't feel creative. So along that wall, before you step into the podcast room, call it the studio, will be turf. So we'll have sleds. That's an area if you want to roll out, if you want to stretch out. If you know the gym's empty-ish and you want to hang out with your friends, the turf's probably a good area. And that'll be probably 50 to 70 feet of turf. Plenty for sprints, plenty for some plyos, med ball tosses, whatever you want to get into. That's one benefit of kind of having the cinder block walls too and not doing too much. You want to do med ball tosses into that wall. It's all already kind of made up for that. At the further edge of that, will probably be like our mini cardio station. So although we are a barbell-based gym, we're not going to have rows of ellipticals. We probably will have some kind of assault bike, maybe eventually upgrade to a rower, maybe a stepper, who knows. One thing I have to keep telling myself, and the boys do a good job reminding me, is this is an evolving project. What we open with in our soft launch, which we'll probably have to do because of COVID, what we'll do at the main launch, and then what we become 3, 4, 5 years from now will be dictated by what we love, what we like, and what our community and our family that breathes air into this thing will need. And so we're going to be ever adapting. And in my head, you know, I like stress about one decision and making the perfect decision where if I don't like this, all right, man, we paint it, we switch it, we move it. And so I need to be a little bit more flexible. I guess that's my type A personality kind of showing through, where I'm pretty lucky to be balanced out by these two in particular. Jim's kind of middle of the road, I think, but these two are a little bit more type B, which is good for me to be around. I used to be high strong type A, and now I've moved a little bit. But it's good. These guys balance my brain and my life out. The bathrooms is what the current physical project that we're working on right now. And to be honest, they just needed a real deep clean. So we dug into that pretty good, bleached the whole thing, cleaned it all out. Again, the gym space has been empty for 8 months now, and maybe even longer. And then we don't know what the care was or what it looked like before that. So there is a lot of just stuff to do. We cleaned the whole thing out. It's actually looking pretty empty, which is a good vibe for right now. Bleached the whole thing. Cobwebs, everything, just crushed it. The boys and I went in there and we crushed that thing. So next we have one wall in there that's cinder block, the rest is tile, and the ladies bathroom. There's 3 showers in both and 2 stalls in both bathrooms. And we're gonna paint that, probably just a similar color to this, keep it kind of matchy-matchy. And then we're gonna set up little stations. We're probably gonna set up some kind of like makeup station with mirrors for the ladies, and a kind of a get ready, you know, mirror station for the guys as well. Probably just some kind of simple wood-ish looking desk. We got some doors to replace. We got some little pieces here and there. We got the lighting. The lighting in general, you'll see in all the B-roll, it doesn't look terrible, you know? It's a little dark, but again, like a dungeony vibe isn't bad, but we really do wanna breathe some energy into this thing. The people are a big piece of it, you know? I think the leaders, us four, are a big piece of bringing that energy, the community, the culture. The people that we attract and this building will attract will be a large portion of that energy, and people don't always consciously do it, but they will be a part of it, being the positivity, being the breath into this. But there are little things, I think, that can really change someone. Say someone has the potential, I guess. Someone's potential positivity, potential energy is fed, just like psychology, nature and nurture. It's fed by where they are. So if we can evolve the potential here. So when someone, you know, little Timmy comes and gets a membership, and Timmy is a very positive person. He has the potential to be a great leader, a positive energy in any building. But if he steps into a dive bar, he kind of closes up, right? If we have really good lighting, really bright, feels alive, feels energetic, smells good, looks good, music's jamming, people are smiling and high-fiving, Timmy's going to come in here and really add to that recipe. Something like, I don't know how many analogies we should go down here. Give it a thumbs up if you like the analogies. Salt. You don't want to just eat salt. Little Timmy's our salt, you know? Connie made the dough. Kai bringing the beautiful homemade tomato sauce. I'm sprinkling some mozzarella homemade cheese on there. Moist mozzarella homemade cheese on there. Homemade moist mozzarella cheese. If you've never had that, ladies and gentlemen, you're not living. And then, you know, Timmy's gonna show up and just sprinkle some red peppers. Maybe some pepperoni. Maybe even some pineapple for you freaks out there. And now we got a beautiful pie that we call home, Third Street Barbell. So that's the general layout we're going with. We're gonna have all the bars you need, specializing in obviously, you know, Texas power bars, things you compete in, squat bars, cambered bars, anything you need depending on how you enjoy to train as an athlete, whether that be an athlete for life, an athlete for a certain powerlifting federation, whatever it might be, we're going to accommodate you in this battle. Or if you just wanna, which is my path, I just wanna hit some heavy squats, I wanna hit a lifetime PR in squats, I wanna squat well over 600 pounds, and then I want to catch a little quad pump on the way out, look real sexy in my short shorts made by 3SB that are coming soon. So that's the goal. I'm excited for it. If you like this video, if you like all meat pizza, give this thing a thumbs up. If you are a freakazoid and absolutely love to put fruit on your pizza for some reason, be sure to give this thing a thumbs up. Ladies and gentlemen, if you like gluten vegan free pizza, give this thing up a thumbs up. And if you like cheese, the basic bad bitch pizza, give it a thumbs up. I appreciate you. Silent Mike, brand new video twice a week. Follow us 3sb.co for any information. Third Street, that's the number 3, Third Street Barbell on Instagram. Thank you guys for everything, man. The love, the support, it's beautiful.